guys, welcome back to the channel. This is episode 7 of the Millennial Classroom. Today we're going to be talking about a situation in our life which is not taking any action on goals. If you find yourself in a place where you aren't taking any action on the goals that you have in life, then this is the video to watch. So let's get started. Okay, so I found myself questioning if I'm taking action on my goals or not. Now, this is obviously a very general thought. Now, it's not only questioning that, but it also gives me anxiety, about, okay, am I working on my goals? Am I not working on my goals? Then I figured that I first got to ask myself why. Now, I've created a table here that might help us understand this situation better. If we aren't taking any action on our goals, according to me, there are three things that are happening within us. Now, these three things are specifically, either we are healing from inside, there's something that has gone wrong in your life that has hurt you emotionally. The reason can be anything. You're healing, so you haven't had the time or the, you know, mindset to take any action on your future goals. Second, you're just procrastinating. There's nothing else happening in your life. You are just pushing your goal, you're pushing your efforts because you're not ready to take action. You're just pushing it to tomorrow. The third thing being, you have decided to take a break. You want to chill. You're very aware of where you are, but you're not ready to do anything in your life. So you're chilling, you're watching Netflix, you're going out and meeting the people around your house, meeting your friends, whatever it is. You're chilling, as simple as that. Now, some of you might even ask me that what if there's a mixture between them? What if there's a mixture between, I'm going through something, I'm healing, but at the same time, I'm procrastinating. I'm also taking a break once in a while. Now, these three factors can also be a mixture. Like in a certain day, you might do all the three things. You might work on your healing. You might procrastinate the work that you have today to tomorrow. Also, you can be chilling. But I think where it boils down to is identifying what's the dominant factor. If there's something that has gone wrong in your life and you are hurt emotionally and you aren't able to come out of it, you are in a mindset that needs time, that needs nurturing, how dominant is that feeling? Has it cured? Is it curing? Is it very recently that you have been hurt and it's taking time? That is one question. How long have you been procrastinating a certain idea for? If you've had a certain idea, if you've had a certain goal that you want to work on, from when have you been procrastinating it? Is it very recent? Has it been 3-4 years since you've procrastinated a certain thing? And how much have you been chilling? Like, is the lockdown period your chilling period, or have you been chilling way earlier than that? Now, I'm saying we gotta first identify what's the dominant factor. Are we healing more? Are we procrastinating more? Or are we chilling more? Once we identify the reason for us not taking action towards our goals, I think then is the final step. We can finally determine what to do. Now, the good thing about it is, as soon as you identify, you're confident about why you're there. And once you're confident about why there's something not happening in your life, you at least know what to work on. The problem is, we aren't even ready to figure out this here. We aren't figuring that out. So we are constantly in the mood of anxiety that, oh my God, I'm not doing anything in my life. I'm not doing anything. Look at everyone on Instagram. Look at what my friend's achieving. Look at what he's doing and look at what she's doing. When am I even going to get there? I'm becoming old. Okay. My alarm just went off. Sorry about that. Okay. I'm getting older, I'm running out of time, I'm running out of ideas, whatever. But as soon as we identify what's the reason of not taking action in our lives, I think it helps us determine what our next step is. If we say that we are healing from something, you're healing from a breakup, you're healing from a certain betrayal, you're healing from losing somebody important in your life, and whatever reason there is, you can spend more time on that. You can immediately say, okay, I'm going to put a break on everything else. I'm going to focus on myself first, become better, feel better on the inside first, and then start working towards the next thing. If we identify that we are procrastinating, let's set a goal. Now, I think one of the main mistakes that we all make is when we know we are procrastinating and we continue to dwell on it. We continue to say, oh, you know what, I'm procrastinating, this is not good, this is not good. Set a date. Say, okay, you've been taking a break for 6 months, give yourself another 1 month. Procrastinate for another 1 month. But decide that after that 1 month, you're finally going to start working towards your goal. And finally, about chilling. I think I read this thing, you must have read it on Facebook as well. Someone said this is a global pandemic and not a, race of who has better hobby or, who's been working out more during the pandemic and all that. Now, listen, I think doing nothing is fine. Like if you want to chill, if you want to watch Netflix all day and if you want to eat, it's completely left up to you. But I think what's important is we decide till when we want to do that. If we don't put a timeline on that, I think that's going to be very self-destructive. And that's what it is. Now the reason why this thought came into my mind is because especially with the whole lockdown, I think there's a lot of anxiety going on. There's a lot of people trying new things on social media, which might look to the others who are not taking action in their life as to they aren't doing anything. But I don't think that's the right perspective. All of us are in our own races. All of us are in our own lanes. And I think we got to understand the pace at which we want to work, the mindset that we are in, and the overall goals that we have. I think if we work enough on that, we can kick out this anxiety of not doing anything and not taking action on our goals. Let me know what you think. Text me or leave in the comment section as to what you think and if you have been in this situation before. And obviously, if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel. I'll see you on the next episode. See you guys. Bye-bye.